Smoke management measures are always being updated and modernized.
To become qualified to be a burn boss in the Forest Service, they have to go through certain levels of training, and one of those involves smoke management. And one of the key pieces of that training is a week-long course called RX410, or Smoke Management Techniques. They go through annual and biannual refresher courses on them. We talk about lessons learned, and it takes a lot of continued training and refreshing of your knowledge to maintain those qualifications.
RX410 covers a broad range of smoke management topics, including characteristics of smoke and health, safety and visibility impacts of smoke, public relations, legal requirements, meteorology, project design, smoke dispersion modeling, and smoke management strategies. Communication is a key component. Forest Service staff work closely with communities to ensure that the public is educated in the purpose of prescribed burning projects. The Forest Service is also diligent in alerting the public in advance of prescribed burning activity so that individuals who are sensitive to the effects of smoke are able to avoid exposure to smoke.
Often when the public sees smoke, it's perceived as a problem, and that's not always the case. And that's where we come in. The process for engaging air quality specialists and monitoring equipment may vary some by region, but generally monitoring equipment can be ordered from a national cache if it's not available locally. Once the equipment and operator are available, it's important to consider a couple of things. First, we partner with state or local air agencies on a shared strategy for monitoring. Next, we determine where the most sensitive communities might be for monitoring, and then we talk about how we'll share the information with the public and deal with public concerns and complaints. Ultimately, we're using that monitoring data to keep the public safe and informed.
As a district ranger, I feel like community support for a prescribed burn program is vital. Here in Northeast Alabama, we have the longleaf pine, we have the endangered red-cockaded woodpecker, and both those things are really dependent upon fire to be successful. And to do that, we want to make sure that the public not only understands, but accepts and supports what we do on the ground. So we spend a little bit of extra time going into the schools and talking to the students about the importance of prescribed burning and what the benefits are. We've done community tours, we've worked with the media, and these are all successful efforts that we've had that allow us to enjoy community support, not just for the prescribed burn program, but forest management in general.